Thanks to Dr. Timothy Nelson for speaking with us about his new book. 1 in 4 New Mexico teens has missed school because they couldn't get period products. That's just one of several statistics the nonprofit Free Flow New Mexico is working to reverse by expanding access to menstrual hygiene for people in the northern part of the state. The organization got its start 3 years ago by distributing menstrual materials and now has 3 self-serve kiosks in Santa Fe where people can pick up a bag filled with everything they might need. Those kiosks are better known as period pods. Each one has free products available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. New Mexico in Focus correspondent Antonia Gonzales recently spoke with the director of Free Flow New Mexico and 3 other people who've been vital in getting one location up and running at the public library branch on Santa Fe's south side.
And I think that'll raise more awareness because even...
What these are they're like the little libraries that you see in your neighborhoods, but instead of grabbing a book, you're grabbing a bag of period products. Each pod holds 300 bags per month. Each one is funded by a different fabulous foundation or community organization, and they are also pod tended.
And what comes in the pod? Like when someone comes and they get, you know, they take a bag, what's in the bag?
Each bag is filled with a 1 month supply of period products, of pads, tampons, liners. And there's also an offer in each bag which allows the recipient to receive either a period cup, period underwear, and so that it's a reusable item.
When it comes to the period pods, have you had any feedback?
We have been receiving amazing feedback from the period pods. Individuals are so excited to be able to have 24-hour accessibility to period products because your period does not wait for a 9 a.m. opening.
What has been the response for these to be here at the library?
Very, very, very positive. We've gotten a lot of questions, and I think it's really raising awareness because people didn't really think about before how inaccessible these can be sometimes. And how often people are having to make that choice. I think a lot of times people think of that as a problem that happens in other countries, and they don't realize that it's something that happens here in the U.S., every community.
Each pod is designed by local artists from that community.
Anyways.
You'll get to see their beautiful work and what inspires them and what has influenced them.
And why was that important to make sure you found an artist from the community to contribute?
It's important to find an artist from within each community.
My name is Selena Fernandez. I am from Santa Fe, New Mexico, and I'm an artist.
For each community to assist itself.
Hola, mi nombre es Israel Haros, Chicano poet, muralist.
So we have pod tenders, and what those pod tenders are individuals within the community that the pod is located, and they're putting together the bags for their period pod, and they're managing it, and the artists are putting it in. And so we're looking for each community to build itself up and to give within itself.
It's important for us as men to understand that cycle. Mm-hmm. And it's part of a moon cycle, it's part of a 28-day cycle, it's part of nature. So in this box, I was putting all the different prayers that I've had this much understanding, because again, that's not biologically happening in my body, but it's also part of our spiritual connection. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We all come from our mothers, we all have to understand those things.
He came in with his masculine energy, I came in with my feminine energy, and that itself was a lesson to be talked about, and how important it is for our young people and then like older people to recognize that, yeah, these things are so correlated and that we do need those two energies to keep this balance. I started doing a couple of stuff, which is my style of the Mexican Nahual style. A lot of codex do see it here, and I mean, I was trying to center the voice of my community, my Mexican community, and just bring in those remedios and that remedy within my art, and remedies that have been passed on through my communities until it got to me and put them in this box. We have Cuatlicue here, who is a goddess, and it's like Mother Earth, and then we have some Xochitl, which is flower, and the bottom I created my own manzanilla or chamomile, and then from there in the bottom you have a couple of other herbs like salvia, hierba del pollo, dahlia, and ruda, which are all Mexican herbs, or herbs that grow in Mexico and that my family has used, generations of their family has used, and people in Mexico continue to use. So that's what I did, and I centered that voice.
In U.S. contemporary times, sometimes we view the period and have really negative connotations to what it is or isn't, and not recognize that it brings life. Irregardless if a woman decides to bring life into this earth, that is part of a life-driving creator cycle. So the different elements that are in here are about creation. So on the top is the Olin and sacred womb design, going back to our ancestral visions. And in the on the other side has different historical ancestral figures that are associated with the moon, with the feminine, with the serpent energy, with different energies that, again, are part of that feminine cycle. I'm really grateful that they're at the libraries, because there's so many things, not just with this, that other resources that our Southside families need to have for free. Yeah. You know, it'd be nice that, you know, we have all these other different types of resources that are necessities that mm-hmm. our community just needs to have.
And what's the importance of having it at two libraries, because the library is somewhere where people are going? It's a place where the community goes.
Yeah, especially since COVID. The library sort of fell into this role of being a community center. Not that we, you know, we always kind of were, but we were doing COVID tests, we were helping people get their vaccinations. And we kind of switched our model to where we were looking at what could help the people of Santa Fe the most. And so whether that was access to library materials, information, or in this case, period products, we want to be able to ensure that every person in Santa Fe has access to what they need to be successful, whatever that looks like.
And what are your hopes for more partnerships, or anything that you hope that this, you know, between the libraries and Free Flow New Mexico?
Well, we'd love to add one to the main library downtown. And anything that we can do to help raise awareness for this issue, whether it's, you know, being part of more campaigns or just being more vocal and posting about it ourselves, and just letting people know that this is an issue and it needs to be addressed.
One out of four low-income menstruators report missing work, school, and other activities. Period products are a basic necessity, and when we supply individuals with their basic necessity, they are able to thrive. We literally have students who have dropped out or have been kicked out of school because of truancy, because they do not have the enough period products to supply for their whole cycle. And they end up missing anywhere from 2 to 4 days of school per month. And those build.
And so what is your hope? I know you said you have a big announcement coming up, but what is your hope for ending period poverty, or at least addressing it in the way that your organization is?
Free Flow New Mexico would love to see every individual be able to strive to their personal success. And having their basic necessities taken care of is a way of doing that. Food, shelter, and period products are all bundled in together.
Wait.
Yeah.